Hello friends, I am NK Jain from Skill on Tech. Today we shall learn and understand about an important member of machine part, that is bearings, classification and types. Video become very interesting, hence please see the complete video. Types of bearing. There are two types of bearings, antifriction bearings and journal bearings. A picture of a antifriction bearing is shown on the top and a journal bearing is shown in the bottom of the slide. As we know, bearings are used in all rotating machines such as pumps, compressors, blowers, lathe machines and several other machines, even though in valves etc. So these play a very important role. So let us know what is antifriction bearings. And provide the support of shaft through mechanical means and in physical contact of surfaces. Examples are ball bearings, roller bearings, etc. The other important bearing which is used to take heavy loads is journal bearing. Make use of pressure wedge of fluid film that forms between the rotating shaft and the bearing. So they support the load by producing a fluid film or a lubricant film between rotating shaft and the bearing. Rely on fluid film, usually oil, to support rotating shafts. The portion of the shaft supported by the bearing is called the journal and is usually hardened for wear resistance. Examples are sleeve bearings, pad bearings, etc. Type of antifriction bearings. There are two types of antifriction bearings, ball bearings, roller bearings. A picture of ball bearing is shown with its different components. Here you can see these are the balls. This is outer race and this is inner race. This is a housing case. Here you can see this is a shaft and this is a cage for keeping the balls intact in the inner and outer race, and this is an assembled view of the ball bearing. So ball bearings are deep groove ball bearings, angular contact ball bearings, self-aligning ball bearings, thrust ball bearings. And in the roller bearings, rollers are used in place of balls. Spherical roller bearings, cylindrical roller bearings, tapered roller bearings, needle roller bearings. Deep groove ball bearings. A picture of single row deep groove ball bearing and a double row deep groove ball bearing is shown. Deep groove ball bearings are the most widely used bearings type and are particularly versatile. They have low friction and are optimized for low noise and low vibration, which enables high rotational speeds. These bearings accommodate radial and axial loads in both directions, are easy to mount and require less maintenance than other bearing types. Hence, these deep groove ball bearings are widely used in the machines. The next ball bearing is an angular contact ball bearing. A picture of angular contact ball bearing is shown, where you can see in this picture that the race bottom side is like this and the upper side is like this. So the angular misalignment in the pump and prime mover or compressor or a prime mover can be easily accommodated by these bearings. Angular contact ball bearings have inner and outer raceways that are displaced relative to each other in the direction of the bearing axis. This means that these bearings are designed to accommodate combined loads, simultaneously acting radial and axial loads. The axial load carrying capacity of angular contact ball bearing increases as the contact angle increases. So you can see in this picture, the contact angle will increase, axial load carrying capacity will increase. The contact angle is defined as the angle between the line joining the point of contact of the ball and the raceway in the radial plane, which I have shown you here. This you can see, along which the combined load is transmitted from one raceway to another and a line perpendicular to the bearing axis. Self-aligned bearing. A picture of self-aligned bearing is shown here. Self-aligning ball bearing have two rows of balls, a common sphere raceway in the outer ring, and two deep uninterrupted raceway grooves in the inner ring. They are available open or sealed. The bearings are intensive to angular misalignment of the shaft relative to the housing as shown in figure, which can be caused, for example, by shaft deflection. Here you can see in this picture, if your prime mover and pump is suppose having misalignment, then these bearings will accommodate the misalignment, angular misalignment, which is shown here in this picture here. Thrust ball bearing. A picture of thrust ball bearing is shown. You can see a picture of single direction thrust ball bearing and a double direction thrust ball bearing. Thrust ball bearings are manufactured as single direction or double direction thrust ball bearings. They are designed to accommodate axial loads only and must not be subjected to any radial loads. So these bearings are only carrying axial loads. So this is a single direction thrust ball bearings. If it will be installed, then it can take thrust load in one direction. But these thrust bearings will take thrust load in both directions, this direction as well as this direction. So these bearings are generally installed in heavy duty valves or in pumps to take thrust load. Spherical roller bearings. A picture of a spherical roller bearing is shown here. You can see the rollers are spherical in shape, and this is a sealed bearing, spherical roller bearing, which is sealed from both sides. So these bearings are called double Z type. If it is open from one side, then it will be a single Z bearing. Spherical roller bearings are characterized by their self-aligning ability and high load carrying capacity. They are designed to accommodate radial load or combined radial and axial loads. Very high load carrying capacity, both radially and axially, these bearings are suitable. Cylindrical roller bearings. As name of this cylindrical roller bearing, the rollers are cylindrical in shape. Picture of cylindrical roller bearing is shown. Cylindrical roller bearings are available in a wide range of design, series, variants and sizes. The main design differences are the number of roller rows and the inner outer ring flanges, as well as case design and materials. The bearings can meet the challenges of applications faced with heavy radial loads and high speeds. Accommodating axial displacement, except for bearing with flanges on both the inner and outer ring. They offer high stiffness, low friction and long service life. Cylindrical roller bearings are also available in sealed or split design, as we have seen in the earlier design of spherical roller bearing. Tapered roller bearing. A picture of tapered roller bearing is shown here. You can see these rollers are tapered. Tapered roller bearings are designed to accommodate combined loads, simultaneously acting radial and axial loads. The projection line of the raceways meet at a common point on the bearing axis to provide a true rolling action and therefore low frictional moments during operation. The axial load carrying capacity of tapered roller bearing increases with increase of contact angle, this angle. If this angle alpha will increase, their capacity will be carrying load will increase. The size of the contact angle, which is usually between 10 degree and 30 degree, is related to the calculation factor E. The larger the value of E, the larger the contact angle. Needle roller bearings. The rollers are in the shape of needles. Here you can see this is a needle roller bearing. Needle roller bearings are bearings with cylindrical rollers that are in a small in diameter relative to their length. The modified roller raceway profile prevent stress peaks to extend bearing service life. There this raceway profile which is shown here, this will prevent the peak stresses. Needle roller bearings in many different designs, series and in wide range of sizes, which makes them appropriate for a wide variety of operating conditions and applications. The other important type is a journal or sleeve bearing. You can see a picture of journal or sleeve bearings here, which is shown. Here in this picture you can see this is a cast iron base and this is a shaft, rotating shaft. This is a oil hole for lubrication and this is a bearing, journal. This portion is a journal. Here you can see this is a shaft and which is rotating inside of this journal. This is a oil hole and this is a hole for bolt for fixing on the frame. The portion of the shaft which is in actual contact with the bearing is known as journal. For every machine and engine, it is necessary to have a provision for the support of rotating shaft. Such support is called bearing. In other words, the shaft must be supported through bearings. Simple bearing is shown in the sketch as I described you. Sliding contact bearings. Sliding contact bearing is categorized by the nature of motion between the shaft and the bearing surface. Here you can see in this picture, this is a journal bearing, this is a pivot bearing, this is a single collar thrust bearing where this collar is provided, and multi-collar thrust bearing where these three collars are provided. In this case, the motion of the shaft is purely a sliding motion, and because of the surface contact, the frictional force is more and hence it requires more lubrication. The sliding contact bearing types are shown in the figure as discussed. Boost journal bearing. Here you can see in this picture, this is a boost journal bearing, boost type, bush of ductile metal, this, and this is a shaft. This portion is a shaft and this is a bush which is fixed in the bearing in the pedestal frame. It is modified form of solid journal bearing and is made up of cast iron rectangular base with two holes to be fixed up on ground or on a plate. These are the two holes which are provided for fixing on the ground on or on a plate. A cylindrical block is surmounted at the top of the base. This is a block, cylindrical block. Plummer block pedestal bearing. The plumber block is a very popular pedestal bearing. A picture of plumber block is shown here. You can see The various components of plumber block is also shown. Here this is a shaft and this is a square headed bolt for fixing the this top portion of with the base frame. This is a collar, this is a body, and these are the bolt for fixing in the plate. The entire assembly shown is used for intermediate support of a long line shaft. The plumber blocks are used where long shafts are used in the machines for transmitting power. Regarding construction details, it is actually classified into two parts. The lower bottom part is made up of cast iron. This one. Is a pedestal, and the upper part is known as a cap. This one. Both parts are attached with each other by means of two square headed bolts. These are the bolts which are connecting both the parts of this plumber block. Foot step bearing. A picture of foot step bearing is shown. A pictorial drawing of foot step bearing. Water portion removed has been shown in the bottom side of this slide here. Foot step bearing is a type of thrust bearing. A thrust bearing, if the end of the shaft terminates by resting on the bearing surface vertically, it is known as foot step bearing or pivot bearing. Here you can see in this picture, this is a shaft and which is resting in this vertically here. This is a base plate and this is a bearing. It is used to support a vertical shaft subjected to an axial load. The lower end of the shaft is supported at the bearing here. This. The bearing is placed inside a hole lined with a ductile metal liner and is supported on a disc pad made up of gunmetal or brass. This. When the shaft rotates, the pad and bush have the tendency to rotate, but the rotation of the disc is prevented by a snug which is provided here for locking of the bearing. There is also a provision of supplying lubricating oil to have a smooth running of the shaft. Thanks for watching the video. If you like this video, hit like button below, share it with your friends and colleagues. Subscribe our channel for getting updates on upcoming videos. Please leave any comments, feedback to improve the videos. Thank you.